Thank you, Perry. The transition of power in Rhode Island's capital city is just days away. On Monday, Jorge Elorza will succeed Mayor Angel Taveras at City Hall. Eyewitness News reporter Kelly Sullivan spoke with Elorza ahead of him being sworn in. She joins us now with some personal details about the mayor-elect that you may have not known before.
Well, Steve, never holding office before, the former housing court judge and law professor decided to run for mayor to be able to give back to the community that he grew up in. So we went to his community and learned more about the capital city's 38th mayor.
Well, I mean, I always want to be connected to the community and connected to the people. Mm-hmm. I grew up not too far from here.
Raised in the city's West End, Mayor-elect Jorge Elorza is close to where he grew up, now living in the Silver Lake neighborhood.
This is my humble home.
Full of color and culture, Elorza showed us around his home full of art.
I love that piece.
And then sat down with us to share a little bit more about himself.
A lot of people don't know much about you. I mean, you are the son of Guatemalan immigrants. They worked in factories. When you were growing up, did you ever envision yourself becoming the mayor of Providence?
No, never. In fact, I always thought that I would never go into politics. It was never my thing, never interested. But, you know, my story is that I barely graduated from high school, but people opened doors for me, and I ended up graduating first in my class in college. I want to open those same doors for other people who perhaps just need that second chance. I also had, you know, a close friend of mine tragically murdered when he was 22 years old, and that was a life-changing experience for me. I left my job in New York City, came back to Rhode Island, and I said I wanted to work the rest of my life in the community.
An avid runner and self-proclaimed foodie, Elorza enjoys the local fare.
I go out to eat a lot. I'm a big sports fan, so, you know, I watch the Patriots and always root for them. I'm a Providence Friars season ticket holder as well, so, you know, I go to some Friars games.
And Elorza says that he's also a Red Sox fan. He says the team teaches kids a good lesson no matter who you root for. You cheer them on when they're good and when they're bad. He says the Red Sox, though, are really going to need the fans' help this year. I'm Kelly Sullivan, Eyewitness News.
Now we turn to next week's transition of power in Providence. Jorge Elorza will take the oath of office on Monday to become the capital city's 38th mayor. It's a daunting task filled with its share of challenges. Eyewitness News reporter Kelly Sullivan sat down with the mayor-elect to discuss what he'll tackle first. She joins us now live in the newsroom.
Well, Mayor-elect Jorge Elorza will be sworn into office in just a few days, and I sat down with him as he talked about how he plans to get Providence moving in the right direction.
You're a housing court judge, you're a law professor, mm-hmm. And then what made you say, I want to become mayor?
Because sometimes I'm not thinking straight upstairs, you know. I'm so excited to get going. And the reason why I decided to run for mayor is because the position gives you so much of an opportunity to make a difference.
A big campaign for you, One Providence. Yeah. Can you describe to all of us kind of what that vision is that you have for this One Providence?
We want better schools. We want a strong economy. We want safe and vibrant neighborhoods. And we want a city hall that just works. So what One Providence means to me is bringing people together from every part of the city, because no one person has all of the answers.
You talked about wanting to add more officers and give them incentives to actually live in Providence. Why?
Now, we have to make sure that the police department reflects the city that it represents and that it serves. And all of these measures will go a long way in making sure that, you know, those relationships between the community and the police are as strong as possible.
So walking in as mayor, you're going to walk into a pretty big budget deficit between somewhere $15 and $24 million. You said you're not going to raise taxes. That's not an option. So what is an option to get rid of that budget deficit?
We pay so much in taxes. At the very least, we have the right to demand a high quality of city services. And I'm committed to making sure we look at every part of our delivery of city services, from plowing to potholes to permitting and whatever it is, to make sure it's as streamlined and it's as effective as possible.
And Elorza says a high priority of his is to work with city council to improve those city services for residents. Live in the newsroom, Kelly Sullivan, Eyewitness News.
Count on Eyewitness News for continuing coverage of the transition of power in Providence. We'll bring you in-depth coverage of Jorge Elorza's inauguration on the air and online at WPRI.com.